Please get ready for exercise 1 from July 2019 issue of Progressive Magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Sir, I rise to support the demands that have been placed before the House by the Home Minister. Sir, I need not remind the House that this year the Home Ministry's demands are being discussed in a context which can be described as almost unprecedented. It is for the first time that we are discussing the demands of this ministry after the country passed through the period of the emergency that rocked the very basic structure of the Constitution and our policy and made the common people of our country realize what they have lost with the eclipse of their fundamental rights and freedom. Sir, the 19 months of rule marked the culmination of a concerted effort to undermine democracy. Those who wanted to destroy the democracy and convert our system into a totalitarian system had looked upon the Home Ministry as the main instrument for forcing their will on the nation. They wanted to substitute the rule of law with a reign of terror, to place individuals above the law, to provide immunity to those whom the group liked, and to harass all those who were looked upon as dangerous to the monopoly of power that the extra constitutional group wanted to preserve. The then Home Minister was himself a captive of this group. It was practically a totalitarian regime and was therefore bound to be a police regime. That is why I would request the Home Minister that the whole police department should be thoroughly overhauled. Sir, I do not want to take the time of the House by listing the various agencies and organizations that were set up in the police department and the home department during emergency. And before that, I also do not want to take the time of the House in describing the fabulous amounts of money that had been placed at the disposal of RAW and other agencies. Even the money was placed at the disposal of certain individuals, and that was exempted from the scrutiny of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India or the Parliament. I do not want to go into all these details, but I would only request the Home Minister, to go into these things and ensure that such things do not happen in future. Under the circumstances, sir, the task of the Home Minister is therefore one of dismantling the police state that was built up by the previous government. Sir, I must congratulate the Home Minister for the excellent beginning that he has made and for the speed that he has acquired to restore the fundamental rights to the citizens and to appoint commissions of inquiry to go into the excesses of the earlier rule, as well as the shocking scandals that had characterized last years of the previous regime. However, in all humility, I must confess that it is not enough. The 42nd Amendment of the Constitution should be withdrawn immediately. The fundamental rights will have to be fully restored, and the role and power of the judiciary must be restored immediately. Then the necessary correction in the attitude of the police cannot be achieved if at this moment we do not differentiate between those officers and men who acted on instructions and those who went out of their way to trouble and harass people during the earlier rule. If we do not differentiate between these people and do not give to the guilty exemplary punishment, that would serve as deterrent and corrective, we would not be able to reorganize the police department. Now I come to the area of general administration, for which the Home Minister is wholly responsible. Our public offices have not earned a great reputation for efficiency. Public petitions and letters remain unanswered and under consideration for months and months together. Public petitions and letters written by the public representatives, councillors, legislators, or members of parliament, even to the ministers, leave aside the officers, remain unanswered or under consideration for years together. Sometimes we do not get a reply at all to our letters. Our people have to suffer because of this. We hope the Home Minister will see that these public offices function efficiently. Even after 50 years of our own government, these public officers, especially officers like block development officers and the public officials do not behave properly, and they even behave very badly with the public. The Home Minister should look into that so that the public officers behave properly and in a manner as to instill confidence in the people that it is their own government which wants to serve them and not to terrorize them. Stop.